It's just a waste of time. Need to open your mind and re-explore these places. Stop repressing your soul. You need to let it go. Let it go, let it go, let it go. All we do is control. We need to let it go. Let it go, let it go, let it go. Set your mind free.
Hello, and welcome to the Synchroflow TV show. Paradigm Shift TV and Operation Bless Everything take you beyond reality TV. This is an alternate reality TV show and a musical. So, the synchro in the term Synchroflow TV show comes from the term synchronicity. Synchronicity is the experience of two or more events that have seemingly unrelated causes and also seem unlikely to occur together by chance, but are observed to occur together in a meaningful manner. It is a coincidence that we give meaning to. It is we, the observers, who subjectively decide that these coinciding incidents have some meaning. Now, I'm not arguing anything. I'm not arguing that synchronicities are more than all in your head. However, I am suggesting the idea that perhaps all of reality is all in your head. And therefore, if we focus on the beneficial coincidences in our life, it may multiply them. Now, the mere nature of synchronicity makes it relatively impossible to prove. What means a lot to me may not mean a lot to somebody else. I may follow a series of events that seem to coincide and have beneficial results, in my opinion. But it's merely opinion and it's always subjective. Synchronicity is a term that was coined by Carl Gustav Jung in the 1920s. The novel The Celestine Prophecy further popularized the term synchronicity in the 1990s. And synchromysticism is a term first coined by Jake Kotze, a filmmaker who was documenting the synchronicities within popular culture and synchronicities that he would discover between movies and television and even the private lives of celebrities with relation to the movies that they were in. Now, as we follow these synchronous links, we'll also be following the synchromystic acoustics from squat parties to St. Paul's Carnival to festivals, and enjoying the music and the conversations that erupt within these synchronous links. This next bit of footage we're going to show you is from the secret garden party, which is probably best described as, yeah, it's a fun fair for adults.
Secret Gardens 2007.
Here's a synchronous link. One of the people who joined us for this random jam outdoors under a tree in Secret Garden, you may recognise as MC Xander, who's best known for his live loop pedal beatbox and singing performances. Later on, Xander would end up living with Daniel Waples, our hand player, with his lady friend, and his lady friend was already friends with our bass player, Arthur Young, who also engineered our Shake and Oak Sessions tracks. So it's a family affair. And if you don't know MC Xander, I suggest you get to know, because he's extremely talented. Deep lyrics, heavyweight bass lines, all created by the sound of his own voice. Uber dope.
Survivors, but that's it, cuss. The buck starts with us. No ifs, no buts. No matter who you cuss. If you're not on the bus, it won't be enough to save you. If you don't reach the ocean, the tide won't turn in your favor. And all those leaving planet Earth will be like, see you later, see you later, see you later, see you later.
So while we were jamming and filming at Secret Garden Party, the Paradigm Shift boys were doing some filming of their own.
My name is Andy Letcher. I do many things.
One guy in particular was talking about mushrooms and the effects that they have on consciousness and culture at large.
I mean, all drugs come with a health warning, a mental health warning, and, you know, I feel like I always forget to say this, but, you know, it's worth reiterating. If you've got family history of mental illness, or you're depressed, or just don't do it. Fine, if you're used to taking them and going down to your local dubstep night, fine, but just do it differently. Do it in an environment where you're not going to be disturbed by your parents or by your headmaster or by a police helicopter or non-trippers. Do it where you can listen to what the mushrooms might be telling you, because it may just have a nugget of information that future generations are going to need.
Someone else who liked to discuss entheogens, shamanism and mushrooms is Terence McKenna, who is world famous for talking about those subjects. Terence McKenna was a self-proclaimed psychonaut, ethnobotanist, art historian, anarchist, environmentalist, platonist, skeptic, and an expert in psychedelics and all of the above.
what civilization is 6 billion people trying to make themselves happy by standing on each other's shoulders and kicking each other's teeth in. It's not a pleasant situation. And yet, you can stand back and look at this planet and see that we have the money, the power, the medical understanding, the scientific know-how, the love, and the community to produce a kind of human paradise. But we are led by the least among us, the least intelligent, the least noble, the least visionary. We're led by the least among us, and we do not fight back against the dehumanizing values that are handed down as control icons.
As an OMI, an open-minded intuitive, I like to stay informed on people's opinions of reality, as well as their opinions on reality-modifying entheogens.
And McKenna himself admitted that he didn't know. Sometimes he thought the mushroom really was this autonomous alien intelligence. Other times he thought that we in the West are so disconnected from our unconscious selves, it is as if we are alienated from ourselves. So the aliens, if you like, are ourselves.
I think they're lying, but I think they just like eating them.
The key to the plant medicines is that there's a deva, a spirit of the plant, and we're totally connected to that spirit, and when we set our intentions, we're able to have a much clearer journey with those mushrooms, and it's to help us break through some of our limited belief systems to really understand the more multidimensional levels that are existing beyond our five senses. So if you are wanting to take it for shamanic purposes, set your intentions and be conscious and in reverence to the plant world for offering her gifts and the gifts to us.
One of the best things I saw on stage in the whole of 2010 was the box sets at the Secret Garden Party. I was on my way to my own gig. I heard something amazing coming from the stage. It was beautiful harmonies, fat beats and fat bass lines, and I was like, what is that? Making an enormous sound, just their voices. One of the best things I saw on stage in the whole of that year. Free.
I've seen, I may not have been, but I can dream about it. Patience is just a waste of time. Need to open your mind and re-explore these places. Stop repressing your soul, you need to let it go. Let it go, let it go, let it go. All we do is control, we need to let it go. Let it go, let it go. Thank you.